How about this one? Is it possible to compliment your child too much? A mom wrote on Scary Mummy saying she admired her daughter's brown eyes so much it made her self-conscious and hurt her daughter's esteem. So are too many compliments a bad thing? Jam, what do you think?
You know, upon reflection, I don't know if it's necessarily a bad thing, but I don't think it's beneficial per se. I think it's all about finding that healthy balance, complimenting your child, praising them, supporting them, but also reminding them on things that they could do to better themselves is absolutely necessary in their personal growth. I don't know, maybe when I become a parent, it might be a different game, but I praise my dog all the time and tell him he is the most beautiful dog in the world.
Aww. But that's positive reinforcement. It works. That's so sweet. It's not that, I guess the question is like, what are you complimenting the kid about?
True.
And I think that this falls along heavily gendered lines for sure. When I had Marquesa and she was born and she started to grow, even actually when she was an infant, it's very clear what our culture does to little girls versus little boys. We are unfortunately guilty, I'm sure I've been guilty, of complimenting looks, the exterior, the physical. And with boys, we often tend to focus on more the physical. And so, for example, saying to a little girl, I love your dress, I love your hair, I love your shoes. It sounds like it's really nice, but what you're actually doing is you're signaling to that girl that, starting young, that it's what's on the outside that matters. And so I posted when I had Marquesa and she was, I don't know, toddler, 2 or 3 years old, and this was happening so much. And you know people mean well, like it's really coming from a sweet place. I love your hair. You're so beautiful. You're so cute. But then you turn around and she starts saying things about her own look. She starts to realize that that's what's important in this culture. So I posted a list of like 10 things that you can say to a little girl as a compliment that have nothing to do with her looks. Things like, I'm so proud of your hard work. You really showed resilience there. Way to go. What's your favorite book?
It's so great.
What's your favorite, you know, it's just reframing how we approach girls and what we're telling them is important about themselves.
I find what you're saying so interesting, and I'm sorry to interrupt. I as you were speaking, it just dawned on me that this is all great advice, but then kids, in particular girls, enter the world of social media, and it's all about likes, and oh my gosh, you're so beautiful, and so it's, I mean, I love the idea of staving that off a bit, but the fact is that they're going to enter this world where it is, unfortunately, social media is all about superficiality for the most part and like superficial likes. So it's really hard to protect kids from that world. Just to circle back to this particular story, though, what I found was interesting was I feel like what this mother did unintentionally was focus on the daughter's otherness. So she came from a couple of siblings. I think there were 3 other kids in the family. They all have blue eyes. Her daughter has brown eyes. Mm-hmm. And, you know, she's constantly complimenting her daughter on the thing that is unique about her, probably with the best of intentions. But do you know, if you have kids, there's always little ears around. So did the other siblings, this is where my brain went, hear this and think, I'm going to tell Sally when, you know, what I really think about her eyes, they're like poo. Like, who knows what little kids, little boys, little siblings, whatever, are saying to her. And that could be leading to it. I just think this is a complicated story, and I'm interested in the nuances of it. But I think ultimately you want to strike a balance with your kids.
I love
Cynthia,
what
I love what you said in the beginning about social. Oh, sorry, Jess. Sorry, I was going to say I love
about
social media. Yes, social media does remind women and young girls that beauty is everything and what you're wearing is everything. But it goes back to what I was saying about that balance. And especially when you are raising your and we're talking about a daughter here, if you're raising your child from a young age and you're reminding them of not only the physical possessions that they have, but their emotional traits, their character, how they did at school, how they're benefiting their community. The more they hear those things, when they grow up and they see it on social media, they're going to be able to go, yeah, okay, that's superficial. I want you to compliment me on my capabilities. I want you to remind me that my voice is powerful. Those are the types of things that I want to hear. And they're going to be able to mute that noise out. They're not going to be fazed by that because they know that everything that they do is not just how they look and what they do, but the character that goes with it.
Oh my God, I love that. And I have to admit that all I got growing up was superficial comments from my parents because all I had were my looks. And it got to be like, I turned into a little monster. My mom would tell me like I had the sweetest neck in the world and I'd go out to a restaurant and lift up my hair and go to different tables and show them how sweet my neck was? So Mel, you were doing the right thing. It got to, I'm not lying, it got so bad that then it moved down to my exterior, my tush. And I was told I had the cutest tush in the world. So guess who started mooning people when they came over? So this is a cautionary tale. How you could create
serious?
An obnoxious child. Although I will say the tush is still burning cute. I got nothing
going
up here.
I can't decipher where you're at right now, Jess. I can't decipher what's happening. Okay.